I welcome you all to the English class, Basic English, first semester. Today's lesson is Expressing Feelings, Chapter 3 in Unit 1. So, expressing feelings, what do you understand this title? Expressing means whatever you feel, whatever is there in the inside, in you. You express in words. Okay. Feelings. Your feeling means your reactions. Reactions to a particular situation. Reaction to a particular incident. Something. Reaction to a particular action. So, why feelings are so important in interpersonal relationship? Interpersonal relationship means the relation between person to person. The relationship with others. Why it is important? Why relationship is important? Because communication is at the heart or a relationship and feeling are at the heart. When we are able to communicate at the feeling level, we eliminate much of the misunderstandings that occur in most relationships. An expression of warmth towards another person almost always brings a response of acceptance, trust, and desire for a closer relationship. If you feel strongly about something, it is important to acknowledge it and make others aware of how you feel. So the last sentence, what it explains is, what you feel, you have to express it. You have to explain it. You have to make it aware others. What is your feeling? Just keeping inside is not good. You have to express your feelings towards what the action done by others. What happened to you? Whether you are feeling happy, whether you are feeling sad, whether you are excited, whether you are not happy, whatever it may be, you have to express it. Feelings are nothing but happy, expressing feelings. Sad, happy, excited, like this. These are the feelings. Now, answer the following questions. How do you feel when somebody slaps you on the cheek? I hope definitely everybody feels sad, disappointed, because it is not a happy thing. So the modal sentence answer is, when somebody slaps on my cheek, I get angry and disappointed. This is my expression towards that action. Next, how do you feel when you score a very low rank in a very important examination? Definitely, it is a bad thing. So, when I score a low rank in a very important examination, I feel disappointed and sad. This is one modal answer to that question. Next, third one. How do you feel when your friends present you a gift on your birthday? Obviously, when you get any presentation gift from others, you feel happy. So, when my friends present me a gift on my birthday, I feel delighted and happy. Next, how does your sister feel when she wins a prize in a chess tournament? Definitely, it is a happy thing. When my sister wins a prize in a chess tournament, she feels excited and very happy. here what you have to remember, very important here is the tense is very much important. How do you feel when somebody slaps you on the cheek? When somebody slaps on my cheek, I get angry and disappointed. I get simple present tense. Slaps is simple present tense. So if the question is in simple present tense, you have to answer in simple present tense. If the question is in the past form, you have to answer in the past form. So that is the thing I want to mention here. Next, activity one. Match the words indicating your feelings in the given situations. Make sentences in the space provided after matching expressions. The situations and the feelings. Left side is situation, right side feel. So first, you smell good food. Then what's your feeling? Definitely, I feel hungry. It's my feeling. Okay. So I think it is common answer. Not angry, hungry. Okay. Next, you see hardworking person. Definitely, when I see a hardworking person or hardworking student, definitely I appreciate, I feel very happy. So happy. You see a jealousy, you see jealousy in a person. Definitely I feel angry. Okay. Next, you read an interesting book. Yes, definitely excited. You watch a popular movie. Thrilled. Like that. Maybe your feelings are different. My feelings are different. So I thought like this. Okay. Now what you have to do is, you have to frame sentence. When I smell good food, I feel hungry. That is the answer here. What you have to write in your notebook is, in activity one, when I smell a good food, I feel hungry. When I see a hardworking person, I feel happy. In that way, you have to write. Reminding. Next, activity two. See, state how you feel, you would feel in the given situations. Remember here, definitely these questions will come in examinations. These questions are, these type of questions will come in examinations. These are very important questions. You can consider them as moral questions and moral answers. Okay. First one. You have watched the news of an earthquake. How do you feel? Earthquake is not a good thing. That is not an enjoyment activity. That's a sad thing. People lost their lives. People also, there are number of human lives, properties, everything will be destroyed. So when I watched the news of the earthquake, I was shocked to see the death of so many people. I felt very sad. Next, India won the World Cup cricket series. And definitely it is a good thing. So I was very happy and excited. You have passed the exams with unexpectedly good marks. You did not expect. So see here, you passed the exam. You passed the exams, past tense. Then definitely your answer must be in the past form. आई फेल्ट अमेज्ड एंड ऑल्सो वेरी हैप्पी. नेक्स्ट, योर मदर आस्क्ड पास्ट टेंस टू गेट राइस एंड यू सॉ वेरियस ब्रांड्स प्राइज्ड डिफरेंट. सो द आंसर मस्ट बी आई वॉज कंफ्यूज्ड ऑफ विच वन टू बाय. Next, you read an article about children working in hazardous industries. Hazardous means dangerous. Very dangerous. I felt very sad. In that way, some other questions are also there. Go through all the questions, read. Okay, understand it and write in your notebook. I also sharing the PDF file along with this video lesson. You can download it and write. Okay. Some common errors. Here, common errors. Common means general, in general. You can see everywhere. That means everybody, anybody can make mistakes, errors, mistakes, wrong. That means especially the person who is using that kind of word feels that that is right. But actually that is not right. It's wrong. See, here left side is incorrect, right side is correct. She is angry at him. Generally, people use angry at him. No. After angry, if you want to convey, if you want to say something about a person, you have to use the word preposition with. If you want to say something about a person's behavior, the anger is at his person's behavior, not on person. The anger is not on that person. The anger is on that person's behavior. Then you can use at. See, second one also is mentioned here. He is angry with her behavior. No, this is wrong. He is angry at her behavior is right. Next, I felt bad. This is wrong. Right word usage is she felt bad. Felt bad is right. Felt, not fell bad. Fall, fell, fell. Fall, fell, fallen. Feel, felt, felt. Both are different, not right, same. See here, feel. Feel, felt, fallen. I feel much tired. I feel very tired. Much and very are different. Just like I explained, feel, felt, felt, fall, fell, fallen. Like what, those are different. In that way, much, very are different. Much is related to uncountable. Uncountable. So generally, we use feel. I feel very tired, not much tired. Okay, very is related to countable. Okay, next. Some tips regarding this chapter. Speak using simple and short sentences. Use appropriate words to express feelings. When somebody is very sad, you should not say, I'm very happy about your sad. Because you are very sad, that's why I'm very happy. You should not say like that. According to the situation, you have to respond. Next assignment. Fill in the blanks with the suitable words to express your feelings. So here I have to take medicine. Why you have to take medicine? Because I am sick. She saw the snake and screamed. Why she screamed? Why? Reason? And I have been working for 10 hours. I am? Yes, definitely he is tired. I am tired. In that way, scared. She was scared. Next, her aunt gave her a beautiful gift. She was, I already just told, when we get gifts from others, generally we feel happy. So, delighted, joy, happy, all are same. So, she was delighted. Next, she had to give a speech. She was definitely people feel you can write both differently. Excited, you can write the excited, or you can write a nervous. She was nervous. They are away from home. They are, yes, definitely homesick. In that way. Okay. The father is shouting at his son. He is angry. Okay. The girl's pet parrot is dead. She is sad. The child is going on a picnic. She is happy. The fox wants to eat grapes. The fox is hungry. In that way, you have to fill them. Okay, write in your pen notebook. Next assignment 2. Write a paragraph using the following hints. No college, no power at home, no TV, nothing to eat, bus strike, theater closed. Using these hints, you have to write a paragraph. Like, one day I was at home getting very bored. On that day, I did not have college and no power at home because of power cut. The TV was also not working. At that time, I was hungry. I thought of eating something, but there was nothing to eat at home. So finally, I thought of going to watch a movie. But for my bad luck, there was a strike. I got so angry and at last I slept. This is the model. You can write it differently. So all of you, I hope you understood whatever I explained. Again, go back and play it again if you don't understand and write notes. Prepare well. Okay. All the best. Thank you. Bye.